the show today, Liberty Basketball's postseason run continues. We'll show you how the Flames kept their season alive.
And we bring you stories of two Liberty alums that are using coaching as a means to impact the lives of young people. That's all ahead on this edition of Game On.
What's up? Welcome into another fun-filled edition of Game On. We're glad you've chosen to join us. As always, alongside Rhett McGibbon, I'm Matt Warner.
Yeah, some powerful stories of faith to get to on the show today. But first, we start off with the feel-good story of the Liberty men's basketball team.
Yeah, why is it a feel-good story? Because it feels so
good
win. And that's what the Flames have been doing in the postseason. Liberty's playing in the collegeinsider.com postseason tournament. Now, they defeated Norfolk State in round one and then drew a talented Samford squad in the second round. Led by former Kentucky and NBA star Scott Paget, the Bulldogs came in with 20 wins under their belt. They would face a Liberty squad that played one of its best games of the season, and it coincided with one of John Dawson's best games of the season. Two early threes got him going on what would be a 15-point night. Liberty's defense, though, the biggest key in their success. They held Samford to 21 points below their season average and turned them over 16 times, one of which turned into that Ryan Kimwright dunk. Flames took a 6-point lead to the half, and they would never surrender it. Five Liberty players finished with double-digit scoring efforts as LU kept their season alive with a 66-58 win. So not only do they advance on to the CIT quarterfinals, but it's also the first time in program history that the Flames have won two postseason games in the same season. This experience for your young team is exactly what Coach Richie McKay was hoping for.
We're getting a third game in postseason. We're playing in the quarterfinals of a tournament, and no, it's not the NCAA tournament, but this is an invaluable experience for your guys. When you're in a situation where you lose, when you lose, you're out.
Yeah.
We felt that in the Big South tournament, and we were ousted quickly. So to have a second chance at it, I think our guys are making the most of it.
So Rhett, Liberty advances on to the quarterfinals. They'll face UMBC on Sunday at 2 o'clock with a shot at the semifinals on the line. Yeah. But as impressive a game as we have seen from them all year long, a young team that just seems to continue to get better every single time out, and that's what you want as a coach.
Yeah, and the youth continues to impress. You know, you think about Georgie Pacheco had some big shots in that game. Lavelle Cabell had some huge shots. And then, especially for me, my own Baxter Bell just defending the post against Walker, a big man, so good down low. Oh, it was absolutely fantastic.
And almost all those guys coming back next year, so they continue to build.
Yeah, definitely good stuff. Well, when the flowers start to bloom, many of us think about baseball, but there is the select few who only know spring football. Those people will be excited to hear that the Flames were back on the turf this week, getting ready for their transition year to the FBS. The Flames will be participating in 15 spring practices, highlighted by the annual spring football game that will be played on April 15th. Overall, the spring practices are an excellent opportunity for the Flames to cover schemes and systems that they will be implementing this coming fall, and also work on some individual skill development, which will be key for this young team that is returning junior BJ Farrow and sophomores Antonio Gandy-Golden and Frankie Hickson. While quarterback Buckshot Calvert had a tremendous freshman campaign, Coach Gill knows the transition to the FBS level will be difficult, and he's excited to see the steps forward Buckshot Calvert takes during the summer.
Well, I anticipate him to really take a big jump ahead as far as he played 6-7 ball games there, and then he had an opportunity to start quite a few good ball games and really perform very, very well in those 7 games there as a starter. I really feel good about where he's at. He's really improved. He's gotten a little bit bigger. He's going to continue to get a little bit bigger. I think the other thing we want to see is how well does he get accuracy out of the pocket, or when he's under distress, is he still being able to be accurate? So those are the things we want him to improve on.
You know, most coaches have the desire to land a job at the biggest program. However, this next coach had desires to land a job where he can make the biggest impact in the community. And this former Flame is doing just that. Meet Butch Jennings.
In Nehemiah 2:20, it says, "He is the one that will give us success, but we, his servants, shall rise and build."
The building process is not new to Butch Jennings. In the early 90s, he built himself into a Division I football player at Liberty University. And then he took to rebuilding his overweight, underachieving little brother, Rashad.
I asked Rashad, "Look at yourself as a 30-year-old man." And he looked at me and I said, "Look at yourself as a 30-year-old man. What will you tell Rashad Jennings now?" That was the biggest thing I've ever asked my brother. And that's what changed his life.
That question and some brotherly love helped reinvent Rashad
setting the course for the NFL career he enjoys today. Butch's love for football and his passion to help young men made coaching a natural fit. He would lead Virginia Episcopal School to 2 state championships, but in his heart, he began to feel a deeper calling.
I said, okay, I'm going to challenge God. I said, I know what I really want. I would love to be at a Christian school, a private Christian school. And I said, I would like to be there to do one thing. I want to work with some urban kids, some minorities. And I said, but God, ain't no school out there like that. And we laughed about it, wrote it on the board, and Habakkuk 2 came to life for me. Write the vision, make it plain so that others can read it. And I kid you, we rode that vision out, me and my wife, for 2 years straight, praying. And I saw this job, and it said urban community job, Christian environment, and it said it was like 75% minorities. I just shook my head, and when we got here, it was awesome.
The here is Valley Christian School in Youngstown, Ohio, a unique environment with a clear-cut mission.
Valley Christian Schools is located in the worst-ranked public school district in the state of Ohio. 615 public school districts. This district is ranked 615. Most private Christian schools are tuition-based, so there's a tuition barrier to getting in. But because of school choice in Ohio, most of our kids are funded with public dollars. So what we're able to do is actually serve a very desperate community in a very unique and Christ-centered way.
And that's exactly the opportunity that Butch Jennings has as the head football coach at Valley Christian.
My motto is filled by passion, but guided by purpose. And that's what we do. These kids are filled by passion to play the game, but I have a responsibility. As they're exercising their passion, I have to begin to guide them by purpose. But also in training these young men, we've discovered something here. These young men are hungry. They're thirsty for knowledge. They're thirsty for Christ. They're ready to go to the next level. They want to change their community. So I decided to partner with these young men, help them change their community. And that's what we're doing together.
And as Coach Jennings begins to build up these young men at Valley Christian, he also has another building project in mind.
Some people would see this, see something tore up, dilapidated. I see opportunity.
Historic Old South Stadium is the practice facility for Valley Christian. But ever the dreamer, Jennings knows with the right help, it can be so much more.
I see a great opportunity to unify this community through this Old South Stadium. And so that's what the real vision is. It's going to take a lot of work. It's going to take the community. But being a Liberty grad, one thing I learned from Dr. Falwell, you know, you can't think small.
And I have the kids sometimes, you know, come down here and say, this is how you rebuild a wall, you know. You rebuild a wall with a brick. But this brick, I always tell them, this brick is you. You got holes in it, and we need to fill it. But I said, when you fill the holes with the mortar, it's to stick back up in here. And I said, that's what we're going to do with this football program. We're going to rebuild this football program. So when I see this, it's a sign of hope. Because I know when something is broken, it's designed to be rebuilt.
Whether it's those taking the field or the field itself, Jennings is always building, always pursuing the vision that God has laid out for him.
He is the one that will give us success. But we, his servants, shall rise and build. It's time to rebuild the youth of Youngstown. We, his servants, shall rise and rebuild together.
Well, after starting conference play this past weekend by taking 2 of 3 against High Point, the Liberty baseball team was back in action on Tuesday in a midweek non-conference clash against James Madison. The Dukes possess one of the most potent offenses in the nation, but they hadn't faced the likes of Xander Klaus. Klaus, making his first start of the season, pitched 4 brilliant innings of one-hit baseball, retiring the last 11 hitters he faced. He was downright feeling. Now, while he was doing that, the Liberty offense started heating up. It would strike for 3 runs in the third. They'd get RBIs from catcher Matt Allen, first baseman Sammy Tarmina. That accounted for 2 of the runs, while a pass ball got the 3rd run to the plate. Then in the 5th, with the score 4-1, veteran Will Shepard providing some insurance, swinging on a 3-0 count. Smashed that one to the gap for an RBI double. And that would be all the scoring for Liberty. It would be all they needed. Flames beat James Madison 5-1 to improve their season record to 12-7. Well, how about that Liberty softball program? They started conference play on the road at Charleston Southern and made themselves right at home, putting their feet up on the furniture and everything. The Flames sweep the series. Amber Bishop leading the way with 6 hits, 8 RBIs in a 3-game set. Alexia Taylor not far behind as she chipped in 6 hits and 5 RBIs. With the wins, the Flames and Winthrop are the only 2 teams in the Big South to start conference play with a 3-0 record.
Well, the Lady Flames tennis team are in the midst of their most difficult schedule in program history. Having lost four straight matches, things would not get any easier with the pesky Maryland Terrapins coming into town, those Turtles. Maryland would jump out quickly in doubles play with their top pairing of Ekaterina Tour and Caroline Williams, dispatching Flames' Rebecca Anderson and Evangeline Chris 6-2. That would propel them on to win the doubles point. Maryland would go on to win the match 5-2, but not before Marielle Hasse would go on to win her 63rd career singles match, moving into third place all time on Liberty's win list.
Liberty Field Hockey senior Serena Barr has been named the National Field Hockey Coaches Association National Scholar Athlete. Can they fit all that on a plaque? She's the only Division I field hockey player in the country to receive the award. Now, to win this prestigious honor, you have to be an All-American who carries the highest cumulative GPA in the first semester of the 2016-17 academic year. Barr is a public health major with a 4.0 GPA, so we have that in common. One of the greatest players ever in field hockey history at Liberty. Congrats to her on one last honor. Coming up after high school, she thought she was done with basketball. Let's see how Liberty helps Jerry Porter rediscover her love for the game and how she's now passing it on to others.
Then I break out some Enfuego sauce. That's when Game On returns.
This is the Graduate School at Liberty University. Since 1971, we've had one goal: to provide a world-class education with a solid Christian foundation to students across the globe. Liberty students learn more than just classroom theory. They get hands-on training in real-world skills and graduate ready to take their place in the world. Whether it's the School of Divinity, an accredited counseling program, or our Masters of Science in Exercise Science, we help today's students become the innovators of tomorrow. And the result? Thousands of graduates with the values, knowledge, and skills to succeed in every aspect of life. Located in Central Virginia, the Graduate School focuses on collaboration with both colleges and professors. It's a place where academic excellence is enhanced by our faculty's personal investment into the lives of each student on campus. A person is defined by more than just a profession, and students aren't just numbers at Liberty. They are individuals gifted by God to fulfill a special purpose, and our faculty use real-world experience to see that our students are prepared to succeed. Liberty University, training champions for Christ since 1971.
I think online learning is a little bit different than in the classroom. The actual online portion gave me an opportunity to be able to be the husband and the father, and then get online and be the student in the evenings. Liberty Online has a partnership with Centra Health, the student tuition deferment program. That allows a student to enroll and pay their tuition out in payments or pay it one lump sum down the road. The degree that I have now that I obtained from Liberty in 2015 online is something that was a prerequisite for this role. So I don't believe I would have this role as it was a minimum to have a bachelor's degree for the role that I'm currently in. So it's helped a lot. We're all so busy in our today life. I think the online option provides an avenue to success, and it provides an avenue to, you know, being able to have the opportunity to go back to school with its flexibility and its schedule.
Hey, welcome back to Game On. You know, so many times in life we lay out our plans for the future, and it turns out our plans don't line up with God's plans. That was the case for Jerry Porter, who thought she was done with the game of basketball after high school. She was wrong, and now after more than two decades in the game, it's clear that she's being used to do a powerful work in the lives of others.
I feel like in the times, in the moments that we've stumbled earlier in the season, it's been because we looked like a team that didn't have a why. And I've challenged you guys about that. The why comes into play when things get a little bit tight, a little bit tense, little bit tough, Then you can revert back to why I'm out here in the first place. What am I playing for? Who am I playing for? What is it that's going to fuel us for the next 40 minutes to get this huge conference win tonight? All right, let's go.
For Francis Marion University head coach Jerry Porter, the question of why she played the game of basketball was a big one early in her playing career.
By the time I came off the floor in high school, I was pretty burnt out. And I felt like basketball was beginning to define me. At the time, I didn't know that that could be a good thing. And I really wanted to really just kind of venture into some other avenues and see who I was beyond the sport.
Despite opportunities to play college ball, Porter chose to attend Liberty University, leaving her jump shot behind and focusing on school.
Liberty had not recruited me, was not one of the schools that had shown any interest. But that was just in my heart, I think, where I knew I wanted to be as a person, as a young person, that was really just looking to grow up and mature as an adult, as a young Christian. I just felt like that was the best spot for me with or without the sport.
But 3 years into her studies, Porter had the itch to lace them up once again. So she paid recently hired Liberty women's basketball coach Rick Reeves a visit.
I actually approached him, sight unseen. He did not know me at all, and said, hey, you know, I'm thinking that maybe I want to play basketball. Would you have any interest in me being a part of your team? I still to this day have no idea what it was that really kind of piqued his interest in me. But he allowed me to come in and be a part of his program. So I stepped into the program for the first year as a senior, as an undergrad senior, and then played that year and the following year as a graduate student.
Porter's impact was immediate, and in her second year, she was named All Big South. But it would be beyond the hardwood where she'd see her biggest growth.
When I graduated from high school, I just, you know, it was my mom's faith, it was my dad's faith, it was the faith that had kind of transcended life for me in terms of who my family was. When I graduated from Liberty, it was my faith, because I really had had an opportunity in those 4 years to figure out why I believed what I believed in, and also to come to an understanding as to who I wanted to be.
When Porter's playing days were finished, she was offered a role on the Liberty coaching staff. But despite being from a family of coaches, she found herself reluctant. Ultimately, it would take a nudge from above for her to accept.
I feel like I was called into the profession. I feel like the Lord had to really kind of change my heart and show me how He could use me in the profession as opposed to just it being something that I wanted to do.
Porter paced the sidelines for 6 seasons as a Liberty assistant under her mentor and former coach before finally getting her first head coaching opportunity at the University of North Alabama.
That was an opportunity stepping into a new role, clearly, because now you're in charge. But it also was a defining moment for me because now you got to figure out who you are as a coach. You got to figure out who you are as a mentor, as the ultimate leader of a program, as opposed to just someone who works for a great leader. You know, you're now that person who people are going to look to make decisions, who the kids are going to look to for guidance.
Porter excelled on the sidelines, finding success at UNA before making stops at Radford, George Mason, and ultimately Francis Marion. While she's collected over 200 career coaching victories, Porter has chosen to focus on a bigger accomplishment.
For me personally, through the course of my journey, though, I have time and time again had to come full circle back to the whole idea of ministry. To work is unto the Lord. It is to be the mentor, the leader, the coach, the mom, you know, whatever it is that these young ladies need me to be, it's to be just that for them.
And after another big conference win on this day, there seems to be no slowing down for this once reluctant coach who is now fulfilling God's call on her life.
When I look back over just the entirety of a 24, 25 year span and all of the women who've come along, and not just the impact I've had on them, but the impact they've had on me and the difference that they have made in my life and the lessons that they've taught me. I just think it's a blessing. And I think that as long as I can stay focused on, you know, wanting to continue to do this job as unto the Lord and not get hung up on the things that eventually are going to fade away anyway, then I can continue to do it and have a lot of joy and a lot of peace about doing it.
Thanks to Jonah Jabbour for that story. You see it with Jerry. You saw it with the story earlier in the show with Butch Jennings. When you're following your calling and the calling God's put in your life, You don't lack for passion. You're not, oh man, I have to go to work today. You love what you do, and you can see that with them. They're following their calling, and they are excited about doing it. And because of that, you see the fruit of it, too, with the impact they're making.
Yeah, exactly. And they're making an impact in the lives of young people. And I think a lot of people out there think, you know, I have to be at, like, Gonzaga or, like, at Kentucky to make an impact. Yeah. But no, they're at these schools that I wouldn't say are, like, well-known across the nation. Like, you've heard of them, but they're not big-time schools in that sport. But they're still making a huge impact in the lives of young people, which is absolutely fantastic to see and right where God has them.
Absolutely. All right, it's time now to light it up. Can we get it? Can we get a little action back here? A little flames? Can we light it up? Do we need the, where's the pilot light? There we go! Warm hot and fuego. You know what time it is. Yeah. Three best athletic performances of the week here at Liberty. And Rhett, we begin, as always, with warm.
Warm. Devin Dockstetter, a name you probably haven't heard of a lot here at Liberty University. He's on the Division II.
Tell me more.
Yes, men's hockey team here. Unfortunately, this group of men just lost their second straight national final game.
They made it to the championship.
Yeah, runner-up 2 years in a row. But Devin Dockstetter, what a career this guy's had. I can remember watching him coming as a freshman, and there's been four Dockstetters playing hockey at Liberty. He was the youngest one. They always said he was the best one, and what a career he had. This season, 34 goals, 47 assists, 81 points, which is a lot considering you're only playing like 35 games. Yeah. And this guy, he's just been a leader. He's so slippery. He must have cashmere on the inside of his gloves. He has such soft hands. Just a skilled player. Yeah. Beautiful to watch. And then when it came crunch time at Nationals, he made the first team all-national tournament team for the ACHA. And this is a guy that just, you know, when space out there got tight, he knew how to take it to another level and was absolutely huge for this group. Even though they lost, he's an absolute beauty in hockey circles.
Yeah, great career. Yeah. All right, moving on now from warm. Who's your choice for hot?
Hot men's basketball. Johnny Dawson, this guy. Yes. I know the offense has been as flourishing, I guess you could say. It hasn't flourished.
I don't know if I say that. That was pretty fancy. But it hasn't come as easily this year for him.
Yeah, it hasn't. But you got to give credit to this veteran guy. He's found other ways to contribute throughout the year, whether it be assisting. His passing game has really come on strong. Rebounding, shutting guys down defensively. Now, he did have a strong offensive game against Samford. 15 points, led the charge for the Flames, and that was absolutely key for them. But it's just awesome to see a guy that, you know, it took him a while to get going this year, and he's starting to go at the right time. You know, I think the boys on the bench know that, you know what, John had a year taken away from him. We want to extend his senior year as many games as possible. He told us it's coming up against UMBC, so he's really just bearing down, and the boys are too, hoping to extend their season.
That's right. The leader of that team doing a little bit of everything in this great season for the Flames, and he'll no doubt be remembered for a long time here in Lynchburg. All right, finally, your choice this week for En Fuego.
En Fuego.
Where are you going to go?
DJ Artis, men's baseball. Yeah. He had quite the weekend against High Point, played solid against JMU as well. But this is a guy, he had a grand slam in game one against High Point, five RBIs throughout that series. He's just, you know, you look at DJ and you're like, last year, a freshman All-American, how can this guy get any better? And it all was about getting low. And he's getting lower in his stance. I knew I'd make you laugh. Getting a little lower in his stance, crouching, and he's, you know, the one thing, I guess, if you could be really nitpicky about this guy was that maybe he needed a little bit more pop in his bat. And I think he's found that with just a little bit more, you know, he's getting down there.
You don't need to show us. We saw the highlight.
You know, and I always want to be a baseball player.
You're going to pull a hammy or something.
Yeah. Seriously. But anyways, great for him. Good weekend. Yeah. Like I said, defensively solid.
Oh, yeah.
And he's so young. He's only a sophomore. So it just, I can't wait to see what happens over the next couple
leading
years.
Leading this team, and you feel like this team is going to be one that keeps getting better as the season goes on.
They will.
The Big South needs to watch out.
They're
coming for you. All right, still to come, we introduce you to the newest member of the Game On team. Stick around. We're coming right back.
Liberty University.
This is no ordinary school.
This is more than an education.
We're here to equip students
to make an impact
on a global scale.
We believe we were created
to make a difference,
to serve God
and each other.
Wherever we are,
whatever we study,
we are
champions for Christ.
We are.
We are.
We are Liberty University.
welcome back to the show. You know, this is a special day here at Game On as we get the chance to introduce you to the newest member of our team, Bobby Bowley. Bobby, thrilled to have you here. You'll see a lot more of her in the coming weeks. But tell the folks at home, out in TV land, a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm sure it's not going to take him too long to pick up where I'm coming from, but I am from the good old state, close to you, Rhett.
Yeah, that's right. 10,000. How many lakes do you have?
10,000. We have a lot. Everywhere you go, 20 minutes, you'll see a lake. I'm from Minnesota. I grew up in St. Cloud, which is like 45 minutes from Minneapolis, if you know the area.
Yeah.
Been passionate about this for quite some time and super excited to get started.
You come here to Liberty University. What sport or what aspect of Liberty are you looking forward to covering the most?
You know, I just got done covering college hockey, Division I college hockey, a little bit with Fox Sports North. And so I'm so happy to cover some basketball. I got a chance to watch you at the basketball game with Richard McKay. And gosh, that team's a fun team to watch. Also, with the football team going with FBS, I feel like it's a perfect time.
There's a lot of fun stuff ahead. And yeah, just keep watching this guy.
I know. I've been watching every movie.
Well, that about does it for us. Excited for the future with Bobby, certainly. As always, you can go to our social media pages, check out much more, including maybe find a little more about Bobby. That's what you want to do, isn't it? And also the website as well.
GameOnLU.com.
Yeah, hit it up. We're out of time. We'll see you right back here next week.
So you've chosen Liberty University. What's next? Well, you could study here or here.
Or way out here.
You could build this, catch that, or play this. Sure, you'll have early mornings, long days, and some longer nights. But that's how we grow. No matter who you are, where you live, or what you want to do, your education starts here.